guys kind of talked about, just, you know, the context of the season isn't much, but to finally get that win, something you've talked about for a long time, but just getting that one, what does this one mean for this program right now?
Well, I mean, it feels great. And as I said to the guys in the locker room, the approach that they brought after the embarrassment on Saturday was what won the game. You know, the 40 minutes between the lines is what you see, but it's the preparation that puts you in a position. And I thought our defensive energy out of the chute, I think we had two steals and a block right out of the gate. Multiple deflections got us out in transition. Got a little rhythm for us offensively. Missed a lot of layups, you know, right there, which generally can frustrate a team. But we did a good job getting back after that. And, you know, I thought Lat, the job he did on Battle in the first half, holding them, I think, scoreless. And Trey, just all game long, you see his versatility going out and guarding Willis, holding him to 8 shot attempts. That's not easy to do. You know, to watch him play, he gets his shot off pretty much when he wants. And, you know, for Trey to apply the ball pressure that he did, you know, still working on his wind and his timing. You know, and then when Battle did get it going, I thought Lat got a little tired for a stretch. We switched Trey over to Battle in the second half, which slowed him down a little bit. That's a tough tandem out there with those two guys. They account for, I think, 50% of their points, and, you know, just two really, really good players. So I thought our defensive energy early is what won that game.
To win the way you did, getting a quick start, building the lead, hanging on to the double-digit lead, was that kind of just to kind of maybe how you would draw it up?
Well, at the start of the second half, that's, you know, we had the same lead, I think, against Michigan, not double figures, but it had a 7-point lead, and they came out through a haymaker at us to start the second half, and then, you know, we're swimming uphill, kept our composure, got a lead back, but we win that game if we come out with the intensity that we did in the second half tonight. So we really challenged them to go out and duplicate what we did early in that game. I thought offensively in the second half we were really good. Alonzo did a great job getting in the paint, making plays. We had some dumb turnovers down the stretch, but, you know, besides those last couple minutes, you know, I thought our guys really did a good job finding the right guy. Bryce had a couple fouls, but he got us going when we needed baskets in a big way. And, you know, again, I just can't say enough about Trey, what he did. I know, you know, he's beating himself up a little bit about the free throws at the end of the game, but, you know, he showed exactly who he is with defensive versatility and just did a phenomenal job guarding two really good players.
You mentioned it, a lot of guys in those first few answers. Everybody that played scored, all your best players, and had to make big impacts in that game. Was this about as total of a team effort as you guys have had this season?
Yeah, from start to finish, I think it's our most consistent effort. And, you know, a couple guys I didn't mention, Derek, was really efficient again and just continues to go out there and make plays. Thought his pick-and-roll defense was phenomenal. We changed it up a little bit from what we had been doing. I thought Eduardo came off the bench and gave us great minutes. The same thing with really good pick-and-roll defense. CJ coming off the bench, hitting 3 big threes against their zone was huge. And then Kobe and Casey also both knocking down a shot. So there's no doubt about it. I think everybody that stepped on the floor made a big contribution and helped that win.
What was the difference with Alonzo tonight being able to put it together for a consistent stretch the way he did?
Yeah, I mean, again, he was start to finish, I thought, as good as he's been all year. He's had really good stretches and flashes, but, you know, for what he did, getting in the paint, making plays, you know, again, the turnovers late, got to clean that up. But overall, start to finish, I think that's Alonzo's best game.
With Minnesota being one of the least turnover-prone teams in the country, how integral was it to the win, you guys' ability to turn them over, and what did you do differently?
Yeah, that was important. They don't beat themselves. They do a great job of taking care of the basketball. And I think Ben Johnson's done a hell of a job with that team, and he's going to do a great job at Minnesota. But the early ball pressure and the deflections is what really got us going tonight. And, you know, when we can get points off turnovers, which has been a weakness, we've been getting outscored, but we doubled them in points off turnovers, which was a huge key. And then we actually outscored a team, probably for the first time all year in second chance points. And just really, you know, proud of the effort that the guys came out with. And now the challenge is to go out and duplicate that on Sunday. You know, had to have two more good days of prep. We can't go in there and, you know, obviously you want to feel good and enjoy it because it's been a long time coming, but you got to put it behind you and get to work and, you know, business-like approach and hopefully win a few more of these games going down the stretch.
You mentioned the two really good practices coming off that loss. The guys just mentioned those as well as kind of the tone setters. You had two good practices and now you got a win to show for it. How important is that just for the team's confidence that has not had that many rewards?
Yeah, it is important. I mean, we've obviously been right there on numerous occasions, and, you know, that's the hard part. I know, you know, you can say it as much as you want, but if it doesn't get in the left column, it doesn't matter. So, you know, the approach for our guys to continue to come in when you've lost, you know, all 12 league games, you know, it's important to keep that mentality and, you know, try not do your best to try not to listen to the noise. Not that it's not warranted, but you got to do your best just to stay focused on the task at hand. Fans were unbelievable to continue to come out and support our team after the embarrassing effort we had this weekend. And, you know, to get a win for our fans that have continued to come out and show the support is important. It's emotional, you know, to go out there and to have that, you know, when things aren't, not many fan bases are going to continue to support like ours have, you know, through this tough stretch. So, you know, again, I know they appreciate hard work, they appreciate toughness, and I thought we showed all those qualities tonight.
Fred, how do you feel off a win like this?
Well, the biggest thing, I think it gives you the confidence to know you can get them. You know, this Minnesota team, all their losses have been to teams in the top 30 net, so it's a good team, much better than what their record in conference shows. They played a lot of close games as well. This league is an absolute monster every time you step on the floor. So to know you can get over the hump and win one of these does wonders for confidence. And, you know, again, put this one behind us the next couple days. We got to come back with great prep and continue to grow and get better. But it does help when you can find a way to get a win to know you can do it.
You mentioned the Iowa game on Sunday. It's been a while since Nebraska's won at Iowa. With all the emotions surrounding that rivalry, what kind of opportunity does that present for you guys?
They're a really, really good basketball team. You know, with as much as they lost last year, especially with the National Player of the Year in Garza and Wieskamp, you know, you got two guys that were drafted in the NBA, and you know, the jump that the Murray twins have made, you know, those guards have stepped in, all of them. Bohannon coming back was huge, and McCaffrey has been phenomenal for them in his sophomore year. So, yeah, I've been really impressed with that team. We're going to have to go in there and fire on all cylinders if we have a chance to win.
It's going to be the difference of the mood in the Hoiberg household tonight.
It's going to be better. I took a breath.